Sabine Hornig is a German artist who was born in 1964. She has studied fine arts in Germany, the UK, and the US, and along with exhibiting her work, becoming a professor and a guest lecturer, she has received working grants of the Senate Science, Research, and Culture in her homestay and in New York. Hornig works both in photography, architectural, and sculpture media. When looking at this photograph, I immediately came to my own conclusion about its meaning. The photograph is divided in half by a wall. To the left, you see a secluded wall. To the right, you see a sidewalk with lights and life. I personally related this to moments in life when a person may feel alone, secluded, cold, and quiet, like the color white of the wall, and that just around the corner, things can change completely, as shown by the contrast with the two halves of the photograph. I saw this as a reminder of how, despite how many people there are in the world, we are all still secluded amongst ourselves while still having so much proximity to one another. Upon looking through Hornig's photographs, I found her preoccupation with frames, windows, portals, and other passageways, primarily square, fascinating. It is clear that this sort of interpretation is indeed most meaningful to her, and that special interest shows through the ease of conveyance in the tones and moods of her images to her audience. I saw this photo as another interpretation of the self, the inside of the room being gray, rainy, dank, and gloomy, and instead of a bright, sunny juxtaposition, we have an outside world that matches the mood and tone of the inside. This is an eerie reminder that peace may not always be found free running in the world. It reminds us that there is war, there is hunger, there is sadness, and sometimes it is a waiting game for the sun to come out. Examining Hornig's work has made me see how composition, lighting, imagery can make such a significant impact on artistic rhetoric. My understanding of these individual elements creates a more meaningful interpretation. I found this image to be very powerful. The contrast colors between the chairs and debris make the audience notice the chair at the forefront of the image. Because we see the image from a slightly elevated angle, the already small chair looks even smaller. I interpreted this photo as a person's inner struggles. There is a wreck inside this room. It is dirty, a mess, and chaotic, representing the monsters that hide within us all: anxiety, stress, depression, and melancholy. While the only thing still in one piece, looking pristine, is that small chair. The chair doesn't appear to stand a fighting chance against the debris. However, it is the last bit of calmness that keeps us all sane until one day, perhaps, the pile becomes too large and engulfs the chair and even possibly shatters the glass window, spilling to the outside world, our breaking points. This last photo reminds us of how looking out from the outside into someone is not as simple as it may seem. From the outside, looking into someone, you may think you have it all figured out, but in this photo, because of all the glaring, the lighting, and the exposure of the film, you cannot quite see what's on the inside and what's on the outside. This causes confusion, which is similar to what we experience in the real world when we meet new people and are quick to make harsh judgments.